Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. This is a follow-up video to the previous video where we discussed the secrets of reality and speculated about who and what is God and not, and life itself, what is it and what is it not, and who and what we are and not. Now, everything is more than one way or another. Everything is good, bad, divine, and evil, because it's all one, as they say. You know, the law of oneness, and, you know, all this stuff that we've heard of already. So we have to keep that in mind, that everything is antinomous and all valent. It's not just one way, and it's not just another, and nobody is in life. No being is one way, completely pure evil, unless there is some beings like that. Or, you know, pure divine, unless they're God, right? With that being said, you know, just about every single being and every single thing in life is not all, you know, real or unreal, or, you know, true or untrue, and, or, you know, good, bad, divine, or evil, and that's it. It's all antinomous and all valent, and for us, because we're not all knowing, it's multivalent. I mean, there's more reasons, there's more meanings, there's more who's, what's, when's, where's, why's, and how's, truths, and untruths. And it's antinomous, meaning it's paradoxical, but still true or untrue. So something that's a paradox can be contradicting, but still both true or untrue at the same time. And that's what life is. So that's breaking out of the box that we've been programmed and conditioned into, where we see things dualistically, like binary code. Like, is it, you know, is it a zero or a one? You know, but there's more to it than that. So we're going to dare to go into this now with that information, with that knowledge and wisdom. So that way, you know, hopefully we won't get caught in any traps while we do this. So I talked about the great central sun in the previous video, and how Christ claimed to have come from the great central sun, or what they said was the region of Barbalo. Now, that may not be the region of Barbalo or the realm of Barbalo, but they claim that it is, and, you know, or, you know, a lot of people believe that it is. So, you know, that's everything in this video is to be speculated, not to be thought as all right or all wrong or true or untrue, not to be believed or disbelieved. I want to remain, you know, in the middle of everything, not going in any direction. And I would like to just put the information, the suppositions, if you will, right there in front of us in one video, so that way we can talk about it in the comments and try to figure it out. So, it says right here, somebody wrote, "We call upon Horus, a warrior aspect of the great central sun, to disentangle us from all interactions with the dark." So, what that says is they're saying Horus is a warrior of the great central sun. But they're also saying that Horus became Ra. So I may have been off in the previous video, or, you know, it's just not really making sense to me. And that's why I said in the previous video as well, just like this, to not go one way or another, because, you know, you don't want to get caught in a trap and offend anybody, or, you know, because they're saying that they're Christ and the Antichrist at the same time, basically. They're saying that they're God and Satan at the same time, that they're all these contradicting things at the same time. So I'm just trying to figure it out, just like all the other people that are, you know, truth seekers. What is the truth then? We want to know. So we got, you know, Horus here connected with the great central sun, right? Or they're saying that. So, you know, we're just trying to figure this out here. Horus, great central sun. I mean, I could be doing this on my own, but I figure, you know, might as well help you guys out. Or we can all help each other out, really. To try to figure this out, like a puzzle, a mystery. It's life itself. The Horus Falcon transmission, becoming a warrior of the great central sun. Becoming a light warrior of the great central sun. So this is all over the place. I guess this was a transmission given to humanity. And this meditation we call upon Horus, a warrior aspect of the great central sun. Now, is Horus the same as Tammuz, or are they different beings? Because that could be a thing too here. Horus and Tammuz. Let's see if they are even the same or not. And now remember, you know, I believe Horus came first before Tammuz. But I don't know. Horus, year of birth. So roughly December 25th is Horus's birthday. And now Tammuz is December 25th as well. And Tammuz was apparently Nimrod incarnated. I mean, Tammuz. Which occurs, it is a month. Ooh. I'll pull out this pizza here. Sorry, guys. So, Tammuz in the Hebrew calendar. Tammuz is the 10th month of the. Oh, that's not it. Sumerian Dimuzi, a Mesopotamian religion, god of fertility, embodying the powers. Alright. It says Tammuz was worshipped as the reincarnation of the sun god Nimrod, and his birthday is recognized up until this day on December 25th. So now, the reason why, you know, I'm struggling here is because they call Nimrod the Antichrist in the Bible. And they worship him as the Messiah at the same time. And now, that's usually what happens, you know, when somebody, you know, when there's two contradicting narratives, you know, we get stuck with this cognitive dissonance and these cognitive distortions, and we don't know what to believe. So, I'm just trying to figure it out myself here. Because, you know, I don't want to get tricked, I don't want to get deceived, and I don't want to get doomed. So, this is for us all to help each other out. Now, is Horus really connected with Tammuz now? And is Horus really from the Great Central Sun? And if Horus is from the Great Central Sun, and that's where Christ apparently claims to come from, if that is the realm of Barbalo, then, you know, things just don't seem right. They're just not adding up. So, but everything's antinomous and multivalent and all that. So, could it be that it's all contradictory, the same thing? I don't know here. We got the Great Central Sun. Let's look that up again. I feel like I'm just going in circles here now. Great Central Sun. The Horus Falcon transmission. The I Am Great Central Sun. The Great... let's just try this. Let's type in their names. Let's type in Nimrod. Let's type in Central Sun. And see if there's a connection here. Let's see. The capital of Nimrod, that mighty hunter before the Lord. Just as Nimrod developed warfare and conquered, some notice the strange similarities between the central sun. It is itself an emanation from the central sun, which is the invisible something. Annual radiation, light radiation from the central sun. The eternal center of all life, binding the whole into unity one. I don't see much about Nimrod, I guess. But we have Horus connected with the central sun. Now, if Nimrod's Horus, though, or Tammuz, then it doesn't make sense. We call upon Horus. I think you guys know what I'm implying here, but I'm not going to say it. I'm implying that things seem to be a setup. And, you know, if anyone knows what I'm saying, go ahead and, but in the comments, I'm not saying it. But, yeah, that bothered me when I saw that. So, I just finished making a video about, trying to help prove who Christ is. And that, you know, we've been deceived and the worship involves Christ. Or I haven't. I don't do that. But, we've been deceived worldwide for all these years. We got the Eye of Horus. Ra was the central sun god, and the obelisk was his symbol. But do you see what the problem is, guys? Let me just show you. Let me just freaking show you. Horus. Horus, Lucifer, one and the same. That's what I was saying, guys. So maybe Gnosticism is a Luciferian deception. They worship Christ as Lucifer, or Lucifer as Christ, a lot of Satanists, and they worship Nimrod, or these other beings. So you see what's going on here, guys? Because they're setting people up to be Antichrist or Antichrist followers. But at the same time, forcing us to pick Christ or Antichrist. Now, it's Horus against Jesus. The meaning of the eye of Horus Lucifer. You've seen the ugly, here's the beautiful. Same guy, Horus Lucifer Mars, a.k.a. Mark Duck, right? Now, this should be very shocking to people, because it's very shocking to me, that's for sure. Horus Marduk, riding the beast, Set, E-A-N key, becoming Horu Set. Marduk Horus, the bull of heaven, supplanted N key, the goat. So we're looking at right here, maybe exposing Gnosticism, or it's antinomous and multivalent. What it appears to be here, though, guys, is the Bible says that he comes from the realm of Barbalo. And if the realm of Barbalo is the central sun, and if Horus is the Antichrist, but therefore also Christ from the realm of Barbalo, then that means Christ is Christ and Antichrist at the same time. So if you worship him, you're an antichrist. And if you don't worship him, you're an antichrist. But, you know, I'm not saying that's what it is. I'm just saying that's what it appears to be here, as you can see, right in front of your eyes. So, obviously, everything's, you know, more complex and beyond our comprehension. And they say, you know, don't eat from the tree of good and evil or knowledge or whatever. Maybe that's why. You know, maybe because everything's paradoxical, not one way or another. I'm not sure. But if we're forced to worship Christ and not the Antichrist, but this being is the so-called Antichrist, then who is Christ? Or are they the same? Or perhaps maybe they're a physical, material, lower aspect of the spiritual Christ? Can someone help us out in the comments? Because I'm really, like, I'm struggling now. I'm, like, glitching out in my mind. Is there a greater central sun? Let's see if there's a bigger sun. The great central sun. This is an incredibly spiritual field and is part of the even greater central sun in our galaxy, Sirius. Let's see. The greater central sun. Interstellar star group revolves around the greater central sun, Sirius, the dog star. Dog star. Dog is the reverse of God. Brightest star in our skies. Sirius is the creator central sun. The Sirius system is the fifth closest stellar system to the sun. The consciousness collective comprising... here, let's skip that one. These stars are suns and central suns. The greater central sun is now positioning within with us also, which means all these violent... means all these violent frequencies of source energy are creating a shift in consciousness, and it is a scale party for everyone. We turn our light body and solar self, God I am, the earth, turn a sun, the sun, a central sun, the central sun, befit a greater central sun, the greater central sun become our even better sun, back to source. The Pleiadians are joyously awaiting the second sun, which will open as we merge, they say. Well, that's what they're saying there. So I'm really not sure where to go with this now. I'm very confused. I feel like we're trapped in a paradox. I don't get it. What does this mean, guys? What does it mean? Somebody tell us what this all means. Because it's very confusing. Christ in Egypt, the Horus-Jesus connection. Is Horus, Set, Typhon, becomes the vicious passion, Osiris, and Horus is Christ, and so on. So they worship Horus as Christ, guys. A lot of people, well, that do, I don't know about, like, a lot, but Horus is Christ, son of the father of the earth, Isis. The male and female combined to create this guy, Horus. Horus is Christ, that's right. Good old Horus, our little friend here. Horus is Christ, it is David, it is your child. You will not ever find your child in the land of Set. What? Isis becomes Sophia. Oh, here we go. Horus is Horos. Set, Typhon becomes the vicious passion. Osiris and Horus is Christ, and so on. So this is exactly what I was, implying that, they were saying, but I didn't want to say it. So what does this mean? So are they like setting us up to be, so they can call people like all these things? Or maybe they manipulated the Bible? Because they got everybody, going against them as Antichrist, right? Because they said in the Bible that Nimrod, ready? The Antichrist. So did they manipulate the Bible? spirit of the Antichrist is Nimrod. Says it right there for you. And the Babylon beast system, right? And what do we see right now? We see, you know, the New World Order and the second Babylon beast system, right? Coming out. The artificial intelligence and microchips and all this stuff. The end time Nimrod, the Antichrist, will still be busy with the building of Babylon when it will be utterly and finally destroyed by God. But if Nimrod is Horus, and Horus from the great central sun, and they're claiming the great central sun is God, but that's Lucifer, then we've all been deceived, and anyone that worships that Christ of the Bible is now an Antichrist the whole time. Because they worship the Antichrist as Christ, right? So that's what I was saying. That's why I'm baffled. I'm mind blown. Because what a conspiracy it is. If it is. Setting us all up to be called Antichrists. Even when we're worshiping Christ or think we are. Who is apparently the same being that they tell us is Christ in the Bible. So, how do we, like, I guess this is the only way to avoid it. It says the truth sets you free, right? So if this is the truth, are we set free from this rigged catch 22, damned if you do, damned if you don't scenario? That means that they made everybody. See right there, the return of Nimrod, the Antichrist, the New World Order. So, now apparently Nimrod has a resurrection chamber to be resurrected by the people of the New World Order. Now, I'm not sure if he's already here or if he's going to be here soon. But let's see here. Resurrection chamber for Nimrod. At least we know the identity of the Antichrist according to this, you know, information here. Nimrod, Gilgamesh, Nephilim, and a resurrection chamber. Here, who will resurrect Nimrod if they haven't already? Gilgamesh. Oh. Gilgamesh, Nimrod, same guy? Wait a minute. I got a video here on TikTok. Let me just get to it for you. I think it's on Truth Talks. If you haven't checked out Truth Talks Live, ladies and gentlemen, please check it out. Truth Talks Live. Let me find that video real quick. And you're going to see some shocking stuff here. Oh, there it is. Rare footage of Gilgamesh's tomb leaked by the U.S. military in 2004, where they have his body right there. So that means they have his DNA. There's Nimrod. So are they resurrecting him? They're going to bring him back to life because he's right there, see? That's him. The real him in that tomb. And the military has him, I guess. So what's the U.S. military do with Nimrod? The Antichrist. There he is. Well, now, why am I so obsessed with, proving all this stuff, or, you know, getting to the bottom of all this stuff? Well, the same reason most other people are. Most spiritual, wide awake, and aware people are people that are seeking the truth. You know, naturally want the truth, obviously. But they're being attacked. They're being attacked by satanic, Luciferian, demonic forces. They're being slandered and framed as the very things that they are. So, how do you protect yourself from being attacked, being slandered, and being manipulated? Or them manipulating other people around you? Like calling you things like, I don't know, antichrist, devil, false prophet, terrorist, rapist, murderer, serial killer, sex offender. You know, all that shit. Well, you recognize that they've been doing it to hundreds of millions of other people all throughout, well, billions all throughout time, and that's their main tactic for taking people out. So, on top of that, what you got to do is you got to say, well, here's the research. We're not the Antichrist, because they're saying everybody is at the same time. Well, here he is, Nimrod, the Antichrist, in a resurrection chamber by the U.S. military, holding on to him, waiting to resurrect him. Well, they already did. In control of the new Babylon, a.k.a. America, and the United Nations New World Order agenda and the beast system, you know, there to doom you. So, with that being said, I think we've unraveled this entire conspiracy, finally, for everyone to know that they deceived you. Not us. And now that we have this information, we can now fight back against them. Together. They no longer believe their lies about our brothers and sisters. The truth sets you free. Here we have. No, you guys are going to dedicate your lives to be anti-evil, anti-lies, and anti-antichrist in his beast system, anti-devil, anti-Satan, anti-Lucifer, anti-NWO, anti-UN, anti-666, all right? Because they want to be anti-whatever. And if they're deceiving us, guys, and they're playing two different sides at the same time with the same being, saying pick Christ or Antichrist, and either way, ha ha ha, we got you, because neither of them are real, or they're both the same being, then what are they doing, guys? Setting you up for doom. Damn if you do, damn if you don't. While they slander and frame everyone, get them taken out, all the truth-seeking individuals that have some of that information. So, I don't want to believe that, you know, they're the same being. I really don't. And I don't. I don't believe that. I don't know what to believe. And so, that's why I'm making this video. Because, regardless of what we don't know, we do know what we do know. We know Nimrod's the Antichrist. According to the Bible, we know he's going to be back if he's not already. We know that they have his body to resurrect him in a resurrecting chamber. We know the U.S. military has his body, or did have his body in, what, 2004 here? Was that 2004, that video? We know that he's Gilgamesh. It's just another name for him. That they use many different names in many different cultures and different places in the on the world. Thousands of years. Now, this, you know, this affects everyone on planet Earth. This matters to everyone on planet Earth. This matters to protect you and your children from deception and from pure evil. It's right around the corner. The end of the world is right around the corner, people. And it's important to know the truth before it ends. And this is our chance to help work together and figure out that truth. Now, let's make some more connections here. Osiris? Right? This is Osiris, guys. Now remember, Enki apparently was supplanted by his son, marked up, aka Nimrod, or Tammuz incarnated, aka Gilgamesh, aka Osiris, aka, you know, he was Ptah and Osiris, and you know the Lucifer, right? So, who do the Hollywood celebrities thank for all their fame and fortune? Lucifer, right? And they call him the devil, and they say they sold their soul to the devil, right? And what do they try to get, guys? They try to get an Academy Award? What was that? An Academy Award. Now, who's the statue? It's not an Academy Award. It's Ptah. What is it? Ptah, Osiris, Hollywood Trophy. What was that trophy called? I forgot. Oh, the Oscar. That's what it is. So, we have right here, look at the similarity between Osiris, Oscar, and Ptah here. So, basically, that's Lucifer. According to our research, you just seen it. They're fighting for a Lucifer trophy. And we know Hollywood's controlled by Satanists and pedophiles and sick fuckers, right? So, what do we do with this information? And as we know, look at all these 666 celebrities, which many of them are mind-controlled, if not all of them. They're fear and trauma-based Illuminati programmed. Many of them don't know it. So they've thrown up the Eye of Horus sign, the 666, the Lucifer 666 hand sign. See them all right there? The AOK sign meaning... sign satanic meaning Illuminati Eye of Lucifer. Ra. And ready, I'll show you. Ra / Lucifer. There we go. So was Jesus Amon Ra, Lucifer, Yahweh, or some combination? Now, I believe the Pope said it himself that, you know, Jesus, son of Lucifer or something. Look at that. See, Jesus is the son of Satan. Is Jesus the son of Satan? But that's a lie, guys. You can't say that, right? The Da Vinci Code, Christ is God, and Jewish Jesus is the son of Satan. Sorry, not the real Christ, right? Just the Jewish one. Jewish Jesus is the son of Satan. Son of Lucifer, right? Or is him? Why are Jesus and Lucifer not called brothers, since the Bible calls them both sons of God and sons of perdition? Jesus is the son of Lucifer, not the son of God. Cold hard facts, deal with it. Lucifer is the bright morning star. Jesus, the son of Lucifer, bright morning star. What is it, the real Christ? I don't think so. I think it's just their version. And it's not just an image. It's a real being. Mr. Marduki, or Marduk, Baal. Jesus is Baal. Their Jesus. See? Lord Jesus is Baal. Beelzebub, Lord of the Flies. Jesus, Satan. What do you know? Reality exposed. And didn't they accuse him of, didn't they accuse the man back in the day of casting out spirits by Beelzebub? They did, didn't they? What do you know? He was him. Or they framed him. What do you think it is?
Well, either way, guys, what do we do now? It seems like reality's been rigged against us all. And we're caught in a catch-22. And it's about to be a world war and the end of the world. And what do we do? What do we do with this information? Let's see, is Baal Zeus? Zeus is Baal. Zeus is Baal. According to these people, Lord equals Baal. Zeus. And they said, hey, Zeus, right? Jesus, hey, Zeus. I can only conclude that Zeus is Baal as Ptah and EA correlate. The eagle son of Zeus is Baal. The father and the son are one. So what's going on, guys? Is he Christ and the Antichrist at the same time? Is he good, bad, divine, and evil all at once? Or have we been deceived? Tell us in the comments. Thank you.